What's going on, everybody? It's ETA Prime back here again with another Launchbox news video. Today, we've actually got two new releases. Launchbox for Windows version 13.18, and we've also updated Launchbox for Android, and this one's coming in at 1.16. With both of these releases, there's fixes, improvements, and new features. In this video, I wanted to go over the more notable new features and new changes with both of these releases. And we're going to start out here with Launchbox for Windows, because with this change, it's something that I've personally wanted to see for some time now. And that's the ability to import multiple platforms at the same time. This is the new Import Multiple Platforms wizard. Okay, so this one's pretty awesome, and to demo this, I just created a new build, and with the newer releases of Launchbox, it'll automatically scan your PC games, import everything, download some artwork, metadata for us. So this is what I've got installed on this machine right now, but I definitely want to install some retro stuff, and we tried to make it really easy with the new multiple platforms wizard. So just to give you an idea, on my desktop here, I've got a folder named Games, and I've got a bunch of different systems in here, different platforms with different games inside of each. We're going to import this whole folder here, and with this new feature, Launchbox is going to be able to decide where everything goes for us. So we're going to head in here, and from Tools, we're going to go to Import, ROM Files, and you'll notice from here, we've got two options, single platform, multiple platforms. We're going to choose Next from the wizard. I'm going to choose Add Folder, Games folder, and as you can see, we've got PSP, PlayStation, Dreamcast, and other systems in here. We're going to select that whole folder. So games on my desktop, choose next, and you can see our folder, Atari 7800, platform, so on and so on. And before we even import here, we can delete one of these if it's something we do not want to import, but I want to go with all of these. So we'll choose next. I definitely want to download metadata for these games, so I'm going to leave this checked. I also want to get as much artwork as possible here. Would you like to specify any custom options? And with what I've got importing right now, I really don't need to use any extra custom options. So I'm just going to choose next. So we've got a bunch to import, 1700 games. We'll choose finish. It's going to import the games. Then it's going to download all of our metadata and artwork. You can see it's already doing its thing in the background. I'm not speeding this up at all. And my internet connection is pretty decent right now. But we've got 1700 games to go through. But remember, with these newer versions of Launchbox, it will download everything in the background for us. So I'm going to let this go for a little while. And there we have it. So we've got our consoles here, 7800, 32X, Dreamcast, Genesis, Neo Geo, PlayStation, and I imported all of these at the same time. Now this really kind of just gives us a fine-tuned control over what we're importing if we want to do that multiple import. And of course, with the recent versions of Launchbox, we do have the auto import. So if you just put them in the correct folder, they will automatically import when you boot everything up. But this is kind of nice if you just kind of want to set up something on, let's say, an external drive and you just want to import a few systems at a time. And since this is a new setup, I might as well go ahead and try to start one of these games up. Once we hit play, it's going to ask if it can automatically download RetroArch and set it up for us. I'm going to choose yes here. Up at the top, we've got our progress bar. Once this is done, we can hit play on that game and RetroArch is set up, ready to go. So yeah, I mean, this is a super easy way for new users to get into this. They can import multiple platforms at the same time for a quick and easy setup. Along with this new feature, we've also made some improvements to a few of the sections here, like our storefront improvements. Tools, Manage, Storefronts. You can now set the auto import per storefront. So let's say you're not using Amazon Games. We can go ahead and disable all of this if we want to. I just wanted to import my installed games, same with GOG and Steam. And another new improvement here, more for power users, set import platform. Personally, I want these to go to my Windows platform, but if not, you can always choose another platform that you have set up already inside of Launchbox. So this is more for power users. It's really up to you, but we've tried to make these improvements just to make it a bit easier on those people. And another new improvement here is the save management feature control. So from our tools, options, save management, You can now totally disable the save management feature here in Launchbox, and this is more for low-powered machines and users that simply don't want Launchbox to keep track of their save files. But yeah, I think this new version of Launchbox for Windows is coming together really nicely. We've got a lot of new improvements, new features, and fixes. Full changelog will be down in the description if you want to head over there and check it out. But like I mentioned at the beginning of the video, we've also got a new release for Android, so let's go ahead and move over there now. This one's been a long time coming for Android, but basically, with this release for Launchbox on Android, we've done a total framework overhaul, or a framework upgrade. The framework we used to use is known as Xamarin Forms. It's now been upgraded to MAUI for better performance, better memory management, and just an overall better user experience on Android. And with this new framework upgrade, when you update, next time you start up, you'll have to migrate your custom themes over so they don't crash on startup. Doesn't take too long, but you will be forced to do this. So we'll just go ahead and hit OK. It'll automatically do this for us. And the next thing we need to do here, just to ensure that all of our custom themes work correctly, is go through an update process with the themes. Now that we've upgraded that firmware, they need to fully support MAUI. So we'll head into our theme updater. Just make sure everything's up to date from there. And then that's it. I mean, you can start playing. We don't have to do anything else. All of our games, emulators, everything's going to be in the same exact place. So from themes, I'm just going to update the Pure theme. Make sure everything's good to go. Download our brand new update. We'll choose OK. And that's it. So yeah, just make sure your custom themes are updated. The default themes will automatically be updated to support MAUI. But if you've got a ton of other themes, it's just good practice to go ahead and do this. So yeah, super glad we've got that framework update out of the way. And with this new update, we've added something that a lot of people have been requesting for quite some time on Android. And that's the ability to import games from a network share drive. And basically, the import process is going to work just like it did in the past, but we've got a brand new option. Network share drive is listed. We're going to choose this. It's going to scan our network, and if you've got one set up, it should show up here. You have to put your credentials in, and you know, if it's your drive, you should know exactly what to do here. And once we're in, we can import our games directly from that network drive. On my share drive, I've got a bunch of games, and what we're going to do here is just import one of these. I'll go with GBA. Launchbox automatically detected the platform, GBA. It's going to scan that directory, let me know which games are in there. We can now import. We'll let this do its thing. And once we get back into Launchbox, you'll see we've got a new section here, GBA. Once we head right into here, we've got access to those games on the network share. Now there is a little icon listed here letting us know that this is a game we're using over network. This is going to work with the default themes and custom themes that support it, but this is a really awesome feature and a lot of people have requested it for a very long time. The way this works is a bit different from local games on your internal storage, but once we want to play a game, it's going to ask us if we want to download and play. We'll go ahead and hit it, so we've got our download progress bar, and then it'll start right up. So the game file is only natively downloaded if you want to play it. And this is really great for Android when it comes to really large collections. A lot of the time, you know, we don't have enough storage on our tablet or our phone to hold every single game we want. So having that share drive and being able to access that on the fly is really awesome. But yeah, overall, we hope you enjoy both of these new updates for Android and Windows. A lot of work has gone into this, and obviously we've got more stuff on the way. I highly recommend checking out the full changelog. Link for that is down below. And another great way to kind of be informed is join the forum. Link for that is also in the description. But that's going to wrap it up for this one. We really hope you enjoy these new updates. And like always, thanks for watching.